Hello, and welcome to the Exponential Smoothing Tutorial Series. In this tutorial, we will demonstrate Brown's simple exponential smoothing function in NumXL. For this example, we will be using monthly sales figures from the last 2 years of a hypothetical company. Let's begin. Start by selecting cell D9. Type in the function name, SESMTH, in the cell or in the equation toolbar. Note that the autocomplete feature in Microsoft Excel will help you find the correct function. Once you find the correct function, click on the FX button located on the left side of the equation toolbar. This will invoke the function arguments dialog box for the simple exponential smoothing function. Using the function arguments dialog box, specify the input cell range. And lock the starting cell in the input range by pressing F4. In the order field, specify 1 for the time order in the series, or simply put the first observation in the input series that corresponds with the earliest date. For the smoothing parameter, you can type in a value or reference an existing cell. In this example, let's reference the value in D1. And lock the cell reference by pressing F4. For enabling and disabling the function's built-in optimizer, you may type a true or false value or reference a cell in your worksheet. Let's reference cell D2. And lock the cell reference by pressing F4. For the forecast time, we will be forecasting the value at the end of the input data. So set T to 0, or better yet, reference a cell in column A so we can change it after the end of the input data. Lock the cell for column movement by hitting F4. For the return type, leave blank or type in 0 for forecast. Then click OK. The function returns NA since we don't have enough data. Copy the formulas to the cells below it. Once you've copied the formulas to the cells at the end of the input data, notice how we change the step value incrementally. Don't worry about the empty cells picked up in and after the end of the input data. The function will ignore them. The multi-steps forecast of the Brown's simple exponential is flat or constant, as is shown in the plot. Let's evaluate the forecasting power of the simple exponential using three functions. Mean squared error, MSE, mean absolute percentage error, MAPE, and mean absolute scaled error, MASE. Select the cell in D4 and type in MSE open parentheses. Once found, click on the FX button found on the left side of the equation toolbar. In the function arguments dialog, specify the cell range for the sales input data. For Y, select the cell range in column D. Don't worry about the empty cells or cells with missing values. The function will examine the value and ignore those observations. Then click OK. For the mean absolute scaled error, MASE, select the cell D5. Then type in equals MASE open parentheses. Once the function is found, click the FX button found on the left side of the equation toolbar. Again, select the cell range of the sales data as X, then press F4 to lock the range, and select the cell range of the smooth time series as Y. Press F4 to lock the range. For seasonality, please leave blank or type in 1 for non-seasonal data. Then click OK. For MAPE, select the cell in D6. Then type in MAPE open parentheses. Once the function is found, click on the FX button to the left of the equation toolbar. Select the sales data cell range as X. Press F4 to lock the range. and select the smooth time series cell range as Y. Press F4 to lock the range. For return type, select 2 for symmetric MAPE or SMAPE, then click OK. That's it! The one-step forecast mean squared error using Brown's exponential smoothing with a 0.85 smoothing factor is 1.2. The MASE shows only a 2% improvement in mean absolute error over a naive reference forecast model. MAPE is also very mild, so we need to do better. Let's try changing the smoothing parameter. That's not good. Now the forecast performance measure looks worse. How about 0.3? No, that's not correct. How about 0.9? No, that's not correct either. In the next part of this tutorial, we will use the function built-in optimizer to find the best value of the smoothing parameter, alpha. We will also examine the improvement in the forecasting power of the model. That's all for now. Thank you for watching!